adapting, right? You just kind of wake up all the acute points and everything. And then this is something he doesn't do. It's the acute point, so you take whatever the center of your palm and go here. There's an acute point right here in your hand. You take the center of the palm and just gently slap it. And then the other side, that point is right here. And then the palm, slap it gently while loosening up the arms and the shoulders. And then the wrist there. And then there's an acupoint right here by the joint. Tap that slightly while loosening up the arms and shoulders. And then there's this one here by the bottom of the knee. Okay, this is one that Joe doesn't do. It's a little tricky if you want to give it a try. It's just, at this point, it's just standing still and moving that one leg. And if you can, you can bring that other arm up a little higher. It's a little tricky, but it's a good exercise. I'm going to try the other one. And ideally, you want to go pretty high.
Maybe we should hang onto a chair.
You can hang onto a chair, yeah. Okay, so, and then these are the teacups. Like you have two cups of teas, soup, hot soup. You don't want to drop them, right? And you pass them back behind. Pass them back behind so that. So if you got a cup of water, right? Whatever. You keep it. Try and keep it. So you don't spill any. And then you try and keep it up so you don't spill any here. This is a little tricky. But let's try a few more times. So here we have the teacups, that, and then up. You can do it with the breath, so it's inhale, exhale, and then bend the knees slightly, okay, so this is the heaven and earth exercise. We're just going to take the hands here and then stretch up with the top one. It's not a hard stretch, it's a very gentle stretch. And this bottom hand will stretch back slightly. And then back center. And then up the other way. Joe likes to keep the head straight. I like to turn the head slightly, but keep the chin tucked in. Ideally, if you haven't had back exercise for a while, what you want to do is keep your back straight. If you feel that your muscles are loose and limber and whatever strong, you can turn a little bit and stretch that way as well. I guess take a few deep breaths. We'll go slightly into the horse stance. And the way I go into the horse stance is I push in with the toes into the ground and pull them out. And then now we're going to push in with the heels and then bring those out. And then we're going to straighten out the toes, push in with the balls of the feet into the ground. So the feet are like shoulder distance apart. Now it's like you're riding a horse, right? And we'll take a few deep breaths in and out. Exhale down. And so we're going to take deep breaths. So as we inhale, we're going to expand the abdomen, expand the middle chest and upper chest, and exhale slowly and evenly. A few more. Inhale up. Now, make sure your feet are flat on the floor when you do this. And exhale down. And then stretch your hands out as far as you can comfortably. Inhale up. Keep your feet flat on the floor. Exhale down. And one more time. Inhale. And exhale. Okay, we're going to keep that same stance. The knees are slightly bent, slightly. The tongue is on the roof of the mouth. The back is straight back here, so you tuck your pelvis forward slightly. And then the chin is tucked in, so the neck is a little bit straighter. Okay, so from here, then we're going to go sideways. So we inhale out, up, and then down. And keep your feet flat on the floor with the weight evenly distributed on the bottoms of the feet. Inhale up.
Okay, let's just have the rest a little bit.